Hello again, and welcome to another episode of Davy's Springtime Saunters, where I take you out onto the walking routes of Edinburgh. Today I've stopped off on my outbound leg, and in particular here at McDonald Road Fire Station, where, as you can see, it is currently undergoing a bit of an extensive refurbishment. And once complete, it will not only be the home of the Scottish Fire Service's Leith and North Central Edinburgh's fire capability, but will also be the Scottish Fire Service's Eastern Division's headquarters. But more importantly, it will see the return to its original home of the Edinburgh Fire Museum, which has most recently been housed up at the Lauriston Place Fire Station, and that in turn has been closed for a few years, and all of the exhibits placed into storage. And talking about museums and fire, Edinburgh has a very close association to the history of fire and fire brigades. And if you go right back to the Great Fire of London in 1666, that saw the first advent of fire brigades setting up. And it was mainly by insurance companies engaging volunteer fire services to put out fires on buildings that they had insured. And if they weren't insured, then these fire services were not called upon. And this went on for a number of years, just using volunteer services. And then, after a couple of fires in the city of Edinburgh, the City of Edinburgh Council sought the expertise of a building surveyor by the name of James Braidwood, who had come up with a theory that buildings and fires within buildings could be fought, determined on how that building would react. And he set up the first ever municipal fire brigade in the entire world. And his services were to be called upon shortly after the formation of this fire brigade, when in November 1824 we saw the Great Fire of Edinburgh. And this started just to the east of Parliament Square in the High Street of Edinburgh, where fire started in a tenement block in Old Assembly Close. And this fire spread all the way down the High Street towards the Tron Kirk. And Braidwood and his brigade fought this fire from either end towards the middle, and thereby saved both the Parliament House building and the Tron Kirk. And Braidwood gained great notoriety for his skills and his theories about fire and how fire reacts within buildings. And he was called down to London, and he was then appointed the master of the London Fire Engine Establishment, which was later to become the London Fire Brigade. And he served them as master for a number of years, until his death in 1861, which quite fittingly happened fighting a fire, which was the Great Fire of Tooley Street on the south bank of the River Thames, where he and another firefighter were working on their part of the building, fighting the fire, and a wall suddenly collapsed on top of the both of them, killing them both. So that happened in 1861, and James Braidwood was buried in a cemetery in Stoke Newington, in the north of London. However, there is a statue erected in his honour in Parliament Square, and quite fittingly, it recognises his contribution to the fire services that have been born since then. And indeed, some of his techniques are still used to this day. So, once this museum opens here at McDonald Road, I hope you'll come along and give it a visit and bring along some of your young, budding children who may wish to aspire to being a future firefighter, because I'm sure it will be an absolutely fantastic attraction and a great addition to those in the city of Edinburgh. Well, I'm going to continue on my walk now, and I'm going to head along towards St Mark's Park and then down onto a bit of the Water and Leith walkway, and then head down towards Trinity and Granton, and then back up through Inverleith and back through the new town, and head on home grabbing something for my tea on the way home, and then maybe watch a bit of the football on the telly tonight. So once again, thank you for your time, and I'll catch you all again next time. Bye for now.